Around about November last year, we started having a few problems with the main van. It was in a quiet period of the year when there's not that much going off on the bike scene. Not many things being bought and sold, just a few projects here and there. So it was quite hard times for us at the time. We got the van home and quickly started stripping it down to diagnose the fault.
That doesn't move anymore.
Quickly diagnosed it was a faulty turbo, or a worn out turbo, should I say. So while we got that off, we decided to rebuild the top end of the cylinder head because it started to get a bit rattly in its old age. 350,000 miles this van's done now. So new turbo ordered, new hydraulic lifters, new rockers, new timing belt, new bearings for the timing belt, new main seal for the front, new injectors ordered. We were well on the path to getting this van rebuilt and back up to full strength. So I taught myself how to time cams up and time up the engine correctly. Got it all back up and running, only to find out that we got low oil pressure. Decided to get the oil pump changed after changing the sensors and the wiring. The oil pump's not a job that you can really do on the floor. You need a specialist ramp, so I took it down to a friend of mine, John at AFP, who quickly got it dragged in pieces and found out that all the main bearings had gone. So after all that hard work, we dragged the van back to base, pulled the engine out and ordered a reconditioned unit and started to pull all the parts off it, ready to bolt onto the new lump. This is so dirty. The idea is, get the engine, which is down here, onto that bench so I can work on it. And then all these parts that are all outside, I'll show you in a bit, need to be washed in this machine. And once they're all washed, I can start rebuilding it. There's been some pretty bad oil leaks on this van, so everything's clogged and crap. It's disgusting. Yeah, I don't think the bench will take a week on its own for too long. I'll have to start moving it up. So we've now been rebuilding this van since late November. It's going to start breaking down. Broke down once in the northeast, which turned out to be this injector, or tools, which causes a lot of other different problems. So we got that repaired, and it broke down again about 3 weeks later in Scotland, and that was turbo going. Bearing in mind I'm not a mechanic, I'm a hobby mechanic, but I'm having to do it. I was a mechanic when I left school for about 3 years, so I decided I would get someone to do the pump. And they got into the job, took the sump off, and they found all pieces of engine in the bottom end of the bench of the engine. That pretty much meant that the main bearings had gone on the engine, so scrap, may as well scrap it. I've actually got those. See how this bit's all copper and that bit's not, and that bit's worn out. And then what happens is you can't build up oil pressure, the oil comes through that hole into that gully, lubricates all the main journal and the crank, and if the gap in between the crank and this is too big, it just lets all the oil out, so then it can't build up pressure to the rest of the engine. So then you're in a position then where your engine lasts probably about 3 weeks at most with low oil pressure. But then it got a brand new turbo on it, so I just couldn't risk it. Just couldn't risk it with that. So, down there, you see the sump of it. It's a brand new reconditioned engine. Just a block head
some crank, everything's all brand new or reconditioned. So, and these are all parts now. I've got a bolt back on. No idea why the bottom end went. The guys who took it apart said it was lack of servicing. I spend a fortune keeping my van serviced and the oil and filters changed. Because oil ain't cheap these days. So, I don't think we'll ever know now. It's an exchange engine, so. By the looks of it, I'm gonna have to go and get some more grease up. It's not quite enough for a pickup car. I've got a lot of degreasing to do, so I need one. What to? What do you put four in?
Four of these. £8 each.
Some more.
This is the van minus its lump. This is the one that's been giving me all the trouble since November. Oh, the van hasn't given me any trouble, it's just not run. The trouble is rebuilding it.
So yeah, off to Alfred's, get some more degreaser. So I've been to get some more degreaser to put in my parts wash. Get a Costa.
When I come back, there's a degreaser everywhere, all over the lot. So this is why we'd run out of degreaser. Because down there, it's pissing out just nicely.
All of this stuff that is £8 a bottle is now all over the floor. Of course it is.
Fix the parts wash. Fix parts wash with a swing bin. Works a treat. We well, have saw you working all the time. That might actually look like a normal video.
Oh, really?
There you go. Yeah, it's working.
You're working?
Yes, yeah, working.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Triggers broke up here.
You can stand there if you want, Ty. Mm-hmm. Moral support. Or you could go make a brew.
That's not a bad idea, that's a good call. Your brews are epic, Gabe.
They are.
Yeah. Not wanting to like be reverse psychological. Yeah. Your brews are just epic.
In other words, Si, we'll make a brew.
No, they're amazing. Aren't they though? They are really good. Good. I mean, not that good, no. He's making one though.
They're standard.
Yeah. They're an average.
They're on par.
Yeah. Actually, the last one I had weren't.
Yeah, they weren't.
But still, yeah.
Si. Still, Simon.
Amazing. Best tea ever. If you like average tea.
Yeah.
Tanning belt cover up. Snapped off.
You broke
buy a new one of them, yeah.
You broke it.
Well, when I was taking bolts out, I didn't realise that that was connected to the lifting eye. So I took that bolt out and engine fell. Yeah. And so engine fell because obviously lifting eyes there, we were unbolting what the whole of the weight was on. So the bolt came out and it went, and just ripped that rear timing belt cover in half. So yes, I broke it.
Oh, wow.
How dirty that is. Doesn't have to be a mint, mate, it just doesn't have to be covered in clark or oil. Dirty. Normally they've got like a jig that you put it in.
It's
like a spit.
Yeah.
It just spins round.
We broke it.
Oh, no, we've got it.
It's getting there, isn't it?
Yeah, we're getting up there now.
It's nice.
Oh,
long way off.
Yeah, it's miles away.
Miles away.
You know. But thanks for reminding me, Connor.
Yeah. You know.
Ooh. Ooh. That falls out, that was
yeah.
Makes that noise,
yeah. I heard it. That's my shikaka.
Shikaka. The thing is that sump now. It, before when it didn't have sump on it sat on that right nicely. Well it didn't because it snapped off bottom of the dipstick off.
Oh,
I'm gonna buy a new dipstick.
Good.
But it was sat on without sump on that little bench and it roared hard, but as soon as you put sump on it, it's just going to fall to one side.
Yeah, and you're not going to catch that.
No.
At this point, we noticed a little bit of damage on one of the camshafts, so quickly got in touch with the engine supplier, who were really cool about it. We just nipped down a Coventry, they swapped it round for us, and then back to carry on the rebuild.
This is the only part that carried oil that remains from the old one. And it could be sludged up, it could be all blocked inside. We don't know, so give it a little play.
You've got one.
This one's white.
We got new parts. These are gaskets for the EGR pipe, and this is for the oil feed. Couldn't get the O-rings separate, and I wanted to replace them because they're quite important. But you can't, so I had to buy the whole bolt.
Or lost, just like that. It's one fitted. It's quite a nice idea. Clip into place. It's the kind of thing that you drop and it lands there. That's an engine. It takes you 6 months to find it. Bit of a gear oil on there, the rubber seals, and what that does is, you probably already know, I don't know, but what that does is, once you tighten up the bolt, you put pressure on the rubber, and if you're turning it and it grips onto the steel in any way, it'll kink it, pull it round, and then you'll not get a good seal on the O-ring. Always oil the rubber seals. And what I do, I use soap if the rubber seal is for water system, and I'll use oil if it's for anything oily. Because you don't really want oil in your water jacket. Now what you're gonna say, it's not an impact socket. Thank you.
So
that is lined up. See it? A little hole. I can push my tool, my dowel tool, my aligning tool in there. That I believe is lined up. So that's aligned. Two arrows are aligned. That one is a little bit off. So I have to get the aligning tool in. That one looks straight. There you go, focus. That looks fairly good. So that's what these bolts are for. Slacking these bolts off. Now I've done a full revolution. Tools and done a full revolution of tightening the tensioner to the correct tension. Oh, it's just a little bit behind, so I'll just adjust that. So we've done a full revolution now, so the belt should settle in. Once we give full revolution of the crank, spot on.
It's the next day. We didn't get everything done. We didn't get it in the van, but we did get the timing done. We did get the cover on. Everything around here is finished. We got the clutch on, got the flywheel on. All the wiring looms in place. Been in, got some oil this morning. Filter. That can be fitted next, and then gearbox on. That's going to be a trick.
seismic. Yeah, that's it. I'm definitely an old man. The young men don't get excited by this kind of shit. Getting somewhere. Ah, it's tricky tools for this.
Yeah. Let's just hope this is not covered in oil and it'll tin up. Because a lot of the time, it won't take. Should be one of them on it. But there isn't. Little waterproof seal. So I'm just going to fit that. Once it's soldered on, can't do that. Not quite straight. That's it. Should do it. Needs to be really tight. Really good fit. That's it. There's some good pressure on it. I didn't know where I'd put the insulation, the little bit of shrink. So I went and got another one. Important this oil pressure. Nice and tight. So this is brand new, the switch just there. So now with the new wire in, it should get a satisfying click when it drops in. Okay. Oh, how satisfying is that?
It's been a while since I took this thing to pieces. I can't remember where most of the things go. Which is nice.
Right, we've got everything connected underneath here now. Apart from that. The only thing I can see that's near it is there. But there's no stub for it. There it is, look, a sneaky little bastard. You see it just there.
I'm absolutely covered in oil. I've been scrolling around underneath it. Been on the road since 4:30 this morning. Got back about 7:30. Spent the last couple of hours on this. And got it to a stage now. There's no power steering pulley on it. No alternator belt, obviously, because that's not on. But I'm to a stage where I can start it. All I've got to do is put oil in it, put water in it, few last checks and it should start up without any lights apart from the alternate light. It looks back. Thank you.
expensive coolant. Too exciting now. I'm ready. Get fired up. Fingers crossed.
Miles this has done.
engines. Don't buy a VW Crafter. But we fixed it. Oh, it's all right, mate. Yeah, just sit in the middle of the road. Yeah, you're fine. Whether to be happy or a little bit disappointed. I've spent about £4,000 on this. Granted, probably about £1,000 that I didn't need to spend. And God knows how many hours. It's had a new turbo, it's had a reconditioned engine, it's had a new flywheel, it's had new timing belt kit, it's had new cams and followers, it's had new clutch. Countless other parts, just little parts, gaskets, seal, and it drives exactly the same as it did before. It's not any better, it's not any smoother, just fine. As it always was until it went. Until it took a big poo.